in Vedic tradition, for beginning any task, like we are doing a dance, the first we light a lamp, representing that very first light that originated. And along with light was the sound, and today's dance is called Dundubi Natyam, the dance of Lord Shiva. Dundubi is the drum of Lord Shiva, from which the whole universe emanated. Shiva is also called as Shankara, and here we have a great dancer with the same name, Shankari Beckman. It is amazing to see her energy as Shiva when she dances. Within a short time, she had actually done this dance with Priya. And she is actually trained in Bharatanatyam. And today she is performing this Mohiniyattam. Mohini means enchanting beauty. And I like to introduce my Mohini, Priya Challe. And very helpless, because with her enchanting divine beauty and love, she makes me say no to anything, especially going for shopping. So now, Shankari and Priya are going to dance as Shiva and Parvati, Gauri. In the beginning of the dance, it is Gauri. She is meditating on Lord Shiva and invoking Shiva. Now Shiva is, you see the pictures where Shiva is represented by having a drum, Dundubi, and on the left hand there is an animal deer, like representing our mind. Our mind is always running. Devi Parvati, now in the dance she will first portray how Lord Shiva is. She says, Lord Shiva is the one who lives in the icy mountains, from which the Ganga flows. And Parvati is Mangala Gauri, the auspicious wife, always beside him. Now I can be close to you. The Vishnu's flute resonates along, and the gentle Veena music is heard, and then Lord Brahma is just stuck with awe. Among them are the Shivaganas, who are also wonderstruck, and the rishis like Narad play celestial instruments like Tamburu. And at this hour, which is called Yamam in Sanskrit, Shiva starts his beautiful Dundubi Natyam, the beating of drum. This Dundubi Natyam is the cause for all creation and is the crown of all arts and sciences. In short, the whole creation emanates from this sound. Now, next, Gauri, she is showing how she chisels the whole universe, keeping the awareness of Lord Shiva. And she enjoys this whole creation of life. All in her speech, sweet talks like the Veena, the rhythmic pattern of life like beating of the drum. Always in her mind she has only one thought of Lord Shiva. To fulfill her desires, she calls Shiva and marries him. You know, marriage is a symbol of sankalpa or intention. Whenever we want to fulfill our desires, we marry. So she wants to fulfill her desire, she marries Lord Shiva. But in this celestial marriage, Vishnu, who represents the knowledge, gives the hand of Devi Parvati to Lord Shiva. They unite in the dance of creation, the Dundubi Natyam. Dundubi brings joy to heaven and earth equally. It is the sweetest Madhura. Madhura means sweet. Sweetest of all the sweetness, including the gulab jamun we have. It gives moksha or liberation. It helps to transcend the energy to Shiva with the pranava sound, Om. Shiva and Gauri, Parvati, are one and the same, like our body energy and our inner awareness. This realization gives moksha, the path led to the, by the light of knowledge. Now we can enjoy that.